Howdy. Have a look around. Have a look around. I sell out of that pretty fast.
Hello there. Here for the show?
What do you have playing today?
The bear. Mm-hmm.
You know, you got a memorable face. Real easy to identify.
Hey, mister! Mister! I never learned your name. I never did.
Hell, there's a face I haven't seen in some time.
You ugly bastard. Jose?
You want to go hunting?
What are you hunting? An elephant?
I wish. No, I saw a huge bear. One of the biggest I ever saw. I reckon nearly 1,000 pounds.
My God. But you need me to come with you.
Of course. Let's go.
You ain't exactly the Virgin Mary yourself.
Just get up before I call someone who'll be a lot less nice.
Fine by me.
Morning to you.
Good morning.
Morning, mister.
Morning to you.
Howdy.
Morning.
Sure. Howdy. Have a look around. Have a look around.
The smell of sheep shit in this town never goes away. Some of the fellers who play poker down at Flatneck Station said they had some clergyman in, drunk out of his mind. Sure, I'm always willing to stack up. All right. Don't really need it, but why not? That's done. Can't hurt. Someone might want it. Ain't nothing special, but sure. Can't hurt. Someone might want it. Appreciate it.
Thanks for your help. Now, let's have a look.
That's mighty popular these days. Fella come in here yesterday says the sheriff been seen with Moira again. I sell out of that pretty fast. That's a fine item right there. Those go pretty fast. Good doing business with you.
And that should be good. Thanks, partner. You okay, boy? It's okay, boy. Easy there. Good boy. Thank you.
Hello there. Here for the show?
Easy. Not too close.
Don't hesitate too long. You don't want to miss the show.
What do you have playing today?
The bear. Mm-hmm.
I need a ticket, please.
We'll be starting soon, just inside the tent there.
Tell you a morality tale from when our country was young that the settlers used to tell about the woods of Massachusetts and the creatures that lived there. One summer, a bear was by the stream, and Old Man Wind appeared and said, "Bear, I shall blow a mighty cold upon the land. Engorge yourself on fish and meat and go find a den. Then sleep, not for one night, but for 60. Go tell all the animals of the forest what I have told you." Bear was sad because the fish were his friends, and now he had to eat them. But he knew to do whatever the wind told him. The animals of the forest often teased Bear and said he was slow and lazy and foolish for listening to Old Man Wind. "You're talking to the wind again, eh?" laughed the rabbit. "I think Bear has finally taken leave of his senses," said the turtle. "And he's getting so rotund that even I could outrun him." "I'm smart and quick," said Rabbit. "I'll outrun Old Man Wind if he comes a-calling, or you, since you're into eating your friends." The turtle said, "If Wind comes, I'll just hide in my shell." Then Bear went and warned Coyote and Possum that they should prepare for a long, cold winter. "It's so hot," said the coyote. "There's plenty of time." The lazy possum said, "Well, there's an abundance of food. Maybe I'll just store some in my pouch." Even his squirrel friends made fun of Bear. They laughed and laughed and squibbled and squabbled. "Chunky needs a nap. Fatty Goody Two Shoes does what he's told." Bear was very sad. But he was a good bear, and he always did what Old Man Wind told him. He went and found a den, snuggled inside, and fell fast asleep. Bear snored and snored for many days. When he woke up, he saw spring had come. He was very hungry, so he walked outside. As the snow melted, he saw all his friends who hadn't listened, frozen and just ready to be eaten. And that's why the bear hibernates. So listen to your elders and do just what you're told.
Thank you.
So long.
Hello, mister.
All hat and no cattle.
Now, say it like you mean it, mister. Hello?
Just can't believe it.
You folks around here actually do any work?
You're just looking for trouble.
Just exactly how dumb are you?
I ain't gonna stand around and take this.
Do I look like I'm in the mood for your crap?
I'm walking away, all right?
Shut the hell up!
Would you just go away?
Working on there anyway.
Just some yarrow and ginseng. Good for the health. Better than that stuff you buy in the store.
Yeah. You can have all this. I'm at the point where I can do it with my eyes closed.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hey there, partner.
Stupid jackass.
I said hello, mister.
Again, hello.
Nikitrin's finally marrying off that nag of a daughter.
Uh-huh.
Getting quick, folks, before I eat all these chops myself.
Yep.
Ain't nothing.
Anyhow.
Finest meat here. No worries.
Welcome to you and your horse. Got some stable space for rent if you're interested.
Anyway,
I'll treat this one well. Well, if that's what you want to go with. I can't tell you how many times I use that one. All right, done. Appreciate it. All right.
You okay, boy?
Some tenderfoot is fine.
Easy, boy. Nearly done, boy. Good boy. Yeah, you all right there, boy?
You know, you got a memorable face. Real easy to identify.
Mister.
I just want to get a drink. I'm parched. Excuse me. Excuse me, but I need some money.
Partner?
I fought in the war.
Hey, fellas.
I fought for you. Give a fella a nickel.
got real bad nerves. I can't work. Can you give me some money?
You're kind of annoying, my friend.
Hey, buddy. I'm too old to get a job, mister. Way too old. Can't we be friends? Hey, buddy.
Hey, mister. Mister. I never learned your name. I never did. You're like a brother, but I didn't learn your name. And I said to myself, Mickey, you never learned that fella's name. Now, you'll never see him again. And you'll be sad. Like when your puppy passed. Because you slept on it. What's your name, mister?
Arthur.
Arthur? My uncle's name was Arthur. Uncle Arthur, we called him, on account of his name. It's a fine name. A strong name. Like a king. You could be my king, Mr. Arthur. Yes, you could.
There. Look out.
Hell, there's a face I haven't seen in some time.
Don't mind me.
And what do you want?
A beer, please.
Alcohol is the only thing that makes the pain of life go away.
You been in town long?
Well, you probably heard everyone talking about the curse here. Maybe not. Folk reckon luck runs bad in this town, and the superstitious among them reckon that ain't no coincidence. Me, I reckon a man makes his own luck. Ain't no church nor curse gonna change it. But what do you care anyway, huh?
Give me a beer.
This'll coat your throat. Another one?
I'll have, whatever you like.
Here's a beer. You looking for a repeat?
Just give me a drink, quick.
Gotta say, appreciate the business you bring here.
Evening.
Somebody get... Hello.
Need another?
Give me something to drink, anything.
We serve real drinks around here, not like that highfalutin Smithfield's place.
I'll have, whatever you like.
Don't drink it too fast.
Hey, partner.
Howdy, sir.
You know, life ain't all bad, is it?
Uh-huh.
Just give me a drink, quick.
This ain't gonna steal your reason, will it? Alcohol's the only thing that makes the pain of life go away.
Poor Otis had a wife to mourn for his life. Three children, they were brave.
Howdy.
Welcome, welcome. Come on in.
Can I get a room for tonight, please?
Room's all yours. Head on up.
nickel.
Oh, my God, you are really pathetic.
Give me something.
Hey, brother.
Hey, mister. Mister. I never learned your name. I never did. You're like a brother, but I didn't learn your name. And I said to myself, Mickey, you never learned that fella's name. Now, you'll never see him again. And you'll be sad. Like when your poppy passed. Because you slept on it. What's your name, mister?
Wish I stayed in bed.
Come on, mister. Come on. Let a fella know. My name's Mickey. Can't we be friends? Ain't no one in this whole damn place wants to be my friend. I'm sad, mister. Real sad. Guess I'll go now.